Hello and welcome to this module 6 on manufacturing systems technology. Quick recap of what we did in the last module. We talked about geometric transformation, specifically with the transformation for a rotation of objects in two-dimensional space. Then we also discussed about how this 2D transformation can actually convert into a three-dimensional transformation. And we studied this in the context of translation, rotation and scaling, and also introduced briefly why it is needed for homogeneity of, you know, multiplication of matrices to describe the whole transformation process rather than having an addition and multiplication separately as was done before for the translation and multiplication for rotation and scaling. Okay. So, we wanted to homogenize the whole thing in the interest of intensive computing or less inexpensive computing and more easier computing, so on and so forth. And we almost sort of created a need for homogeneous transformation process. So, what is actually homogeneous transformation? So, in the geometric transformation methods, we have a non-uniform method of describing translation, which is actually v dash equal to v plus d distance matrix, scaling, which is v dash equal to some scaling matrix times of v, and rotation about some axis, which is again v dash matrix into rotation times v. So, the non-homogeneity is coming from the fact that while equation 1 is a addition equation, equation 2 and equation 3, they are multiplication equations. So, homogeneous transformation can be realized, I will call this HT in short, realized by mapping an n-dimensional space into n plus 1 dimensional space. Now, what does it mean really? It means that one more coordinate needs to be added to the three coordinates already existing so that x, y, z can be converted as x, y, z and some dummy coordinate w. We call it intentionally dummy coordinate because it is only a something which is added for the sake of clarity of calculations. Okay. So, obviously, now if I looked at how to convert this equation 1 into a multiplication of matrices, I would say that adding on a new coordinate 1 or w or anything. In fact, you know what we can do is we can scale these coordinates and normalize these coordinates in w which forms x by w, y by w, z by w and 1. Okay. So, this is how you can actually look at this. It is more or less a scaling issue, and w is the scale factor that can be utilized to map these coordinates in this manner. So, I can say that this can be translated by a matrix 1 0 0 dx, 0 1 0 dy, 0 0 1 dz and 0 0 0 1, and this you multiplying with x, y, z and 1. Okay. Let us look at whether it is formulating what we need really. So, here the first variable comes out to be x plus 0 y plus, which is 0, 0 z plus dx. The second variable comes as 0 plus y plus 0 again plus dy. Okay. And the third variable comes out as 0 plus 0 plus z plus dz. Okay. And the fourth comes at 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1. So, essentially what evolves is x plus dx, y plus dy, z plus dz and 1, which is nothing but x dash or x prime, y dash, y prime, z dash, and 1 as such keeps, you know, as a dummy variable intact even if you do the homogeneous transformation. So, this is a sort of bright way to convert the addition of matrices into the multiplication just by looking at or changing the space from n dimensions to n plus 1 dimension, or introducing a new coordinate to the matrix space. You can actually convert that into a homogenized multiplicative process. So, therefore, all you need to do is to add this coordinate throughout, whether it is rotation or whether it is scaling, and formulate a set of new, you know, equations where you can all by multiplication do the transformation. So, that is called homogeneity. So, therefore, now if we really summarize it, for the addition of matrices, you write a matrix 1 0 0 dx, 0 1 0 dy, 0 0 1 dz, 0 0 0 1, okay, as the transformation matrix for addition. So, you can call this as a matrix for translation. For scaling, the matrix can be just in the same manner, you have to change the order of the matrix. So, you have the diagonal matrix Sx, Sy, Sz and 1, and remaining all are zeros. So, that is how it will be for scaling, and obviously for translation V dash now would be equal to the matrix H times of the matrix V. For scaling, the V dash would be equal to the matrix S times of the matrix V, and for rotation, and it is plane based again. So, you have now rotation in three directions, that is rotation along Z, which could be represented by the matrix cos theta minus sin theta, 0 0 sin theta cos of theta, 0 0 and 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. Okay. Similarly, you have Hx and you have Hy. Hx could be 1 0 0 0 0 cos of theta minus sin of theta 0 0 sin of theta cos of theta 0 and 0 0 0 1, and similarly Hy, which is actually cos of theta 0 sin of theta 0 0 1 0 0 minus sin theta 0 cos of theta 0 0 0 0 1 as the rotation about the y axis. And so therefore, the rotation vectors or vector equation for or the transformation equation for the rotation can be, if it is about the z, we can say this is v dash is h z times of v. If it is about the, we can call it v dash z. If it is about the x, we can call it v dash x is h x times of v. And if it is about the y, we can call it h y times of v. And these are the three transformation equations apart from the ones which we have already told for translation and scaling. So, this completes the three dimensional transformation process, number one. Number two is it is a homogeneous transformation, that all the transformations are continued by doing matrix multiplication. Okay. And therefore, the complexity of the computations or the expense of the computations are subsequently reduced because of that. And so, now we can easily say that if you had a series of transformations to an object, for example, let us say you wanted to rotate the object, you wanted to linearly translate the object, you wanted to scale the object altogether, you all need to sort of make a series of multiplier matrices. Let us say these are the n transformations that you have done onto a vector v. So, you are multiplying it with h 1, h 2, h 3, so on up to h n. So, there are different transformation matrices which come out because of rotation, because of scaling, because of whatever. And so, this is a generic equation which comes up now for any kind of transformation which can be computationally performed on a computer by you know, as many number of transformations as possible to an initial coordinate system v. You can predict the final coordinate system in this way. So, now if you had the situations where you wanted to blow up an object or let us say scale an object or maybe you know, translate an object or maybe assemble an object with another one. So, you are moving it in space and trying to mix and match two different objects. All you need to do is this transformation generic equation that has been pointed out here. And this is also known as compounding or concatenation of the transformation matrix H. Okay. So, it is all mathematically now become very simple, that all you need is to know what all are the transformation matrices, and all you need is to know what is the initial coordinate space, and you will get the dimensions for the final coordinate space. So, let us actually now do a practical example problem where we try to do this transformation as shown in this example problem here. There is a 3D object which is shown on the left figure somewhere here. So, this is the object. Okay, and there is an orthogonal coordinate system x, y, z which is having an origin around this point O, and the object is not placed at the origin, okay, it is away from the origin. And we know what are the existing vertices of this particular object by looking at the different points A, B, C, D, E and F. You can see these points being marked on the figure here, okay, and these coordinates are already known to you. You have to rotate this object by 30 degrees. Okay. And that is too in the clockwise direction. So, seeing from the, if it is and this is the rotation is about the point D and around the y axis. So, therefore, what you are trying to do is to sort of rotate this object by 30 degrees around this y direction in the clockwise as seen from the positive side. So, basically you are trying to rotate it in this manner, okay, around the y axis. So, you can see here in fact how the rotation has happened. Okay, so, the object has rotated from the position A, B, C, D, E, F to A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash and F dash. Obviously, D, the line along which the rotation has to take place are same, meaning thereby D dash and E dash are same as D and E. Okay, the remaining are all rotated, and you have to calculate the coordinates of the final position of the object given the initial coordinates of all the points A, B, C, D and E. So, essentially it is a series of transformations that you have to do. Obviously, you cannot rotate the object, you cannot rotate the object as it is on the position that it is in, because you know the rotations all happen when the objects are centric to the origin. So, therefore, you have to somehow be able to bring back the object first to the origin, and then from there you would perform all the transformations so that you know the object, the final coordinates can be mapped. So, essentially you first bring this object to the origin and then perform the rotation at the origin, as you can see in step B and C, and then again translate the rotated object back in space to the initial point D that it was in order to do this transformation. So, in the next module I am going to sort of work on trying to tell you how this transformation would be possible mathematically and how you can actually solve this transformation equation.